Hello everyone, I'm Brett and welcome back to Math Hacks. Today we are going to learn some fast and easy formulas for factoring quadratics. Factoring quadratics is a critical algebra skill, but it can be burdensome to learn because there are so many different techniques. The formulas I'm going to be teaching you today are going to act as a shortcut for factoring quadratics that involve perfect squares. By the end of today's lesson, you'll know how to factor the difference of perfect squares as well as polynomials who factor into binomials squared. Let's get started. So we're looking at problems that involve factoring with perfect squares. And one of the most common types of problems that you're going to stumble across is factoring a difference of two perfect squares. So the formula commonly given for this is a squared x squared minus b squared factors down to ax minus b times ax plus b. Now, all these a's and b's are a little bit confusing. What they really mean is that if you have a perfect square coefficient on an x squared term or something that can be written as something squared, and you subtract from it another perfect square, then it can factor in this way. Now the thing to remember is that one is a perfect square, so you're not always going to have a coefficient on x squared, but one squared equals one, which multiplied with x squared is simply x squared. So you can also think of this as simply x squared minus b squared would factor into x minus b times x plus b. And that's a perfectly fine case of this formula. In fact, this first problem we're going to look at doesn't have a coefficient on the x squared term. It is simply x squared minus 9. And because 1 times x squared is the same as x squared, this fulfills our formula. So the first thing I want to do is take a look at this and figure out what a and b are. So a is simply going to be 1, which again I really don't have to do anything with if it's 1. X squared, and then b is going to be the square root of 9, so 3, since 3 squared is 9. Now what I want to do is just rewrite it in this formula. So this is going to become 1x minus 3 times 1x plus 3. Of course, I don't have to write the ones on this because 1 times x equals x, so this is the same as x minus 3 times x plus 3. The reason this factorization works is because having the exact same values except for the sign in the middle makes it so the middle term drops out. And let's just go ahead and FOIL this out to give you a sense of how that works. So x times x is x squared. X times positive 3 is positive 3x. Minus 3 times x is minus 3x. And minus 3 times positive 3 is minus 9. Now you can see that plus 3x minus 3x equals 0. So I'm just going to cross those two out since they cancel out, and I'm left with x squared minus 9. And you see, that's where we began. So whenever you have a perfect square minus another perfect square, we can factor it into this formula. This time we do have a coefficient on x squared, so the first thing I want to do is make sure that this coefficient is also a perfect square. So because 4 can be rewritten as 2 squared, it fits the formula. And 25 is the same as 5 squared. So I get that a equals 2 and b equals 5. So what I'm going to do now is just go ahead and rewrite our factorization according to our rule. So we get 2x minus 5 and 2x plus 5. Again, the opposite signs here will ensure that the middle terms drop out and we are left with 4x squared minus 25. Now we're going to take a look at a more difficult problem. And what makes this one so difficult is when you look at it, it doesn't even look like it fits our pattern here. We have a 1, which is the same as 1 squared. And we can write a 1 squared in front of this to take care of the a, but this x to the 8th power just doesn't look like x squared. Now the trick here is that we can rewrite x to the 8th as something squared. And to do that, I'm going to rewrite it as x to the 4th squared, because x to the 4th times x to the 4th equals x to the 8th. So that's the first thing I want to do. Now that each part is something squared, I can go ahead and apply this formula. So that's going to look like 1, and then x to the 4th, because remember I'm taking the square roots of each part, minus 1, and then I'm going to do the same but change it to a plus sign. Of course, I don't need to write the 1s on the x to the 4th terms because 1 is implied. So this is the same as x to the 4th minus 1 times x to the 4th plus 1. The tricky part about this problem is that after factoring out the difference of perfect squares, we are left with this factorization that we can factor even further. So you'll notice that we have a difference of 2 perfect squares here. Again, this is a perfect square that isn't very obvious because I would need to rewrite x to the 4th as x squared squared so that it is in a squared form. So this is the same as x squared squared minus 1 squared. And when I rewrite it like this, I see that I have something squared minus something squared, and so I can use our formula again. All right, now I get x squared minus 1 times x squared plus 1 times x to the 4th plus 1, because I just want to go ahead and carry this down with it. Now, you're not quite done, because once again, we have another difference of perfect squares. So x squared minus 1 is the same as x squared minus 1 squared, which fits very nicely into our formula. So this is going to factor down to x minus 1 and x plus 1. And then I'm just going to carry along the x squared plus 1 and the x to the 4th plus 1. There you go. Now we have it in the fully factored form. Now we're going to take a look at a couple more of these factoring formulas. So there's a couple other patterns that you might see come up in some problems, and if you can spot those patterns, you can take the shortcut and factor them into these factorizations. So in this first problem, I have 3 terms, and I notice right away that I have a perfect square on the first term and the constant. So I'm going to look at these 2 formulas that I have here and see if I could match either of them up. Because my trinomial has all plus signs, I'm going to compare it to this first equation. Now the trick here is, although we have the squared term on the first and the last, so we have an a squared and a b squared, we need to ensure that the middle term is the same as 2 times ab. So in this case, my a equals 2, since 2 squared is 4, and my b equals 5, since 5 squared is 25. That means that this middle term needs to equal 2 times a, which is 2, times b, which is 5. If it equals that value, then I can use this arrangement to factor it. So let's check that. So 2 times 2 is 4, times 5 is 20. So this equals 20. And that checks out. Now here's the nice part. I can use this shortcut. I can use this formula to quickly factor it. So this is going to be equal to ax plus b. So a is 2, so 2x plus b, which is 5, times the same thing, 2x plus 5. And because these are the same binomials, I can simply write that as 2x plus 5 all squared. So that is the factorization. So the handy thing about these formulas is that if your polynomial fits into one of the formulas, you can quickly just jump to factoring it without having to do any thinking, basically. You just plug in the numbers. So that's really nice. So for this problem, we have 4x squared minus 12x plus 9, and we want to see if this trinomial fits any of the patterns in our two formulas here. Now, because I have a minus sign on the middle term, I'm going to try to match it up with this second formula. This second formula is almost identical to the first formula, it just has minus signs in it. So I still want to figure out what a and b are, and then I want to multiply them together and times them by 2 to see if 2ab is the same as my coefficient on x. So first, let's find a. So a is the square root of the coefficient on x squared. So a is going to equal 2, since 2 squared is 4. B is the square root of this constant term. So b is going to equal 3, since 3 squared is 9. Now for our formula to work, we need 2 times a times b to equal 12. So 2 times a is 2 times b is 3. So we get 4 times 3, which is 12. So again, this one checks out as well. Now all we have to do is plug our a and b into the formula, and we have the factorization. So that's going to look like honestly, the hardest part about any of these problems is simply remembering the formulas. So you have these two formulas, which are pretty much the same. If you have a plus sign in the middle, it's going to translate to a plus sign in your binomial. And if you have a minus sign in the middle, that's going to translate into a minus sign in your binomial. And we also had, don't forget, this difference of perfect squares formula up here, which basically said if you have a perfect square minus another perfect square, you can factor that into the square roots subtracted and added. The success of this channel depends on viewer support. So if you liked what you saw and would like to see more math tutorials like this one, give this video a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Till next time, I'm Brett, and thank you so much for joining me.